In the PreTrig review part 11, we go over techniques for solving equations, including the quadratic formula and the zero product property. Let's look at example A. We have a rational equation, 2 over 5x equals 4. All we need to do here is cross multiply. So the 5x is going to multiply the 4, so we get 2 is equal to 20x. We're going to divide both sides by 20, and we will get that x is equal to 1/10. Moving on to example B, we have a quadratic. X squared is equal to 20 plus 8x. So the first step is to get everything on one side. So we'll leave the x squared where it is because it's positive. We're going to subtract the 8x from both sides. So this will become minus 8x on the left-hand side. And we have to subtract 20. And then the right-hand side is now 0. So we're looking to factor. We need two numbers that will multiply to be negative 20, but will add to be negative 8. So we start going through the factors of 20. So we would have 1 and negative 20, 2 and negative 10, and that's it. So we have a positive 2 and a negative 10 that we want to use. And since the leading coefficient is a 1, we know that we can just write these as our factors. So we have x plus 2 times x minus 10 equals 0. Now we're going to make use of the zero product property, and we set each factor equal to 0. So x plus 2 has to equal 0, or x minus 10 has to equal 0. And if we solve each one, the first one, we get x is equal to negative 2. Solving the second one, we get x is equal to 10. Moving on to example C, again we have a quadratic. So let's take a look at the factoring. We would need two numbers that multiply to be negative 6, and that would add to be negative 6. So as we go through, we've got 1 and negative 6, 2 and negative 3. Neither one of these adds up to be negative 6, so that means that the quadratic is prime. When the quadratic is prime, we're going to have to use the quadratic formula to solve it. So now we know we've got x is going to be negative 6 plus or minus the square root of negative 6 squared minus 4 times 2 times negative 3 divided by 2 times 2. Well, let's clean this up. We've got 6 plus or minus the square root of 36, and then there's a minus sign here and a negative 3 here, so that's going to turn into plus. 4 times 2 is 8 times 3, 24. 36 plus 24 is equal to 60. So we've got the square root of 60, and in the denominator we have a 4. Remember our list of perfect squares we went over in an earlier part of the review, and we know that 4 goes into 60. So if we come off on the side here, radical 60 will be radical 4 times times radical 15, which is 2 rad 15. So we can rewrite this as 6 plus or minus 2 radical 15 divided by 4. Now, 6 and 2 have a common factor, which is 2. So we can factor out a 2, and we would have 3 plus or minus radical 15 divided by 4. And now we can cancel. We have 2 goes into 2 once, 2 goes into 4 twice, and finally we have that x is equal to 3 plus or minus radical 15 divided by 2. In example D, we have an equation that involves a radical. So the first step is to isolate the radical. So we can have x minus 3 is equal to radical x plus 3. It's always a good idea to make sure that your radical is positive. It's one less negative sign to have to keep track of. Now we'll use the technique of squaring both sides. So we're going to take x minus 3 squared is equal to radical x plus 3 squared. And of course, remember to be careful when you square both sides, you know you're going to have to check for extraneous solutions. On the left-hand side, we get x squared minus 6x plus 9. And on the right-hand side, we get x plus 3. We're going to simplify our equation by combining like terms. So we're going to bring the x to combine with the negative 6x and the 3 to combine with the 9. So now we have x squared minus 7x plus 6 is equal to 0. And this is a pretty easy factorization. X minus 1, x minus 6 is equal to 0. Now we're going to use the zero product property, and we have x minus 1 is equal to 0, or x minus 6 is equal to 0, which means we get x is equal to 1, or x is equal to 6. Now remember, because we squared both sides, we have to check for extraneous solutions. So we plug in always to the original equation. Let's check x is equal to 1. And if we plug that into the original equation, we get 1 minus the square root of 1 plus 3. And we're asking ourselves if that equals 3. So we have 1 minus, well, this is going to be the square root of 4, which of course is 2. And 1 minus 2 is negative 1, which definitely does not equal 3. Therefore, we have to reject the x equals 1 solution. Now let's go ahead and check x equals 6 into the original equation. So we have 6 minus the square root of 6 plus 3. And we're asking ourselves if that is equal to 3. So we have 6 minus the square root of 9, and the square root of 9 is 3. And yes, that does equal 3. So this equation has only one solution, and that solution is 6.